Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be explaining non-uniform quantization. So this session is about non-uniform quantization. Now see, what is non-uniform quantization? If quantization characteristic is not linear, then step size is not constant. It means quantization will be non-uniform quantization. Like see, if you see my previous session where I have explained you linear quantization, where if I say I have output over here and I have input over here, then we have seen two different categories, mid-trait and mid-riser. But in both of the cases, if you see the center line which is passing through characteristic, so that was this. So here, this characteristic that was linear for uniform quantization, where you will be observing step size for mid-rise as well as mid-trade, you will be finding step size was constant like this. So this was linear quantization. But in non-linear quantization, characteristic is not linear. It means step size is not constant. So that quantization, that will be non-linear quantization. So in non-linear quantization, step size is changing with respect to input signal. Now see, in non-uniform quantization, step size will reduce with respect to reduction in input signal. So quantization noise will decrease. So this is one basic advantage which is there with non-uniform quantization. I'll explain later, like see how we have reduced our noise by providing non-uniform quantization. And practically we can achieve non-uniform quantization by using compounding. So that is even a case that I'll explain in next video, how we can practically apply compounding method to have non-uniform quantization. In this session, I'll explain only non-uniform quantization and how it reduces quantization noise. Non-uniform quantization, that is generally used for speech and music signal. So you'll be observing non-uniform quantization that is utilized in speech and music signal. So this is what about basics of non-uniform quantization. Now to understand non-uniform quantization, it is very compulsory to understand crest factor. So let us define it first. So crest factor that is peak value of signal divided by RMS value of signal. So crest factor, that is peak value of signal divided by RMS value of signal. Peak value, if I say it is X max, and RMS value, if I say that is X min, sorry, X RMS. Then crest factor is X max divided by X RMS. Now see, when you talk about crest factor, so crest factor is usually high for speech and music signal. So that one should have basic idea about it. Like see, crest factor that will be high for music as well as speech signal. Why? The reason is variance of signal is very high. So crest factor will be very high for music as well as voice signal. Like when you observe speech or voice signal, you will be finding it is so random like this. Right? So where this is amplitude of signal and this is time. So here this variation that is very fast and it is so random, So crash factor for this type of signal, that will be extremely high. So let me mention here, for music and speech signal, crashed factor is very high. Now, to define crash factor with power of signal, I'll be explaining you what is signal power. Now, basically, we already know signal power, that is, if I say it is P, then that will be X square T divided by R, where XT, that will be mean value of signal, and R is equals to 1 for normalized power. So we can say power is equals to X square of T. So now see, we have basic idea about what is crash factor, that is maximum peak value of signal divided by RMS value. For speech and music signal, it is very high. And signal power, that is P, is equals to X square T by R, where R is 1 for normalized value and XT, that is mean value of signal. So now I will try to correlate this power with crashed factor. So let us try to have a relevance in between crash factor and power. So see, as we have defined, crashed factor, that is CF in short, that is X max divided by X RMS. Now see, X RMS means what? It is root mean square value. So one can calculate that by square root of XT square. See, that is how we can calculate it. And as we have calculated, power is what? X square T. So if you place that value here, you will be getting, this will be X max divided by square root of T. And for normalized signal, we can say X max, that is equals to 1. So now you will be having crash factor, that is 1 divided by square root of T. And even one another relation that one can have, power is equals to 1 divided by crash factor square. So this is how crash factor and power of signal is related to each other. Now see, one more thing that one should know, like for non-sinusoidal signal, signal to noise ratio, that will be 3 into 2 to the power n into P, where P is power. Now, for non-sinusoidal, basic formula is this. Now, one basic logic that one can try to understand here, like see, as I have told you, for voice and speech signal, crash factor, that will be very high. So for voice and speech, crash factor, that is high, means it will be very greater than 1. If this crash factor is very greater than 1, then power will be very less. So power will be very less than 1. So in that case, what will happen? signal to noise ratio will decrease. So SNR that will get poor. Why? The reason is, if crest factor is very high, power will be very low, and if power is very low for non-sinusoidal signal, SNR is 3 into 2 to the power n into p, where n is number of bits and p is power. So for speech and voice signal, or one can say music signal, SNR that will be very poor. Now, by using non-uniform quantization, all we do is we change step size with respect to signal. So for weak signal, we decrease size of step, and for strong signal, we increase size of step. So that will improve SNR. So if you don't use non-uniform quantization, for voice and speech signal, in that case SNR will be poor. But if you use non-uniform quantization, in that case for weak signal size of step will be less, and for strong signal size of step will be big. So in that case you will be improving SNR, signal to noise ratio, means you will be having higher SNR of quantization. So quantization noise that will decrease by using non-uniform quantization for higher value of crest factor signals. So as I have discussed earlier, like see, if you have this type of signal, so in that case one can understand, like this is non-sinusoidal signal first of all, and here peak value and RMS value is having very big gap. Like say peak value is over here and RMS value will be somewhere over here. So ratio of peak divided by RMS, that will be very greater than 1. It means crest factor will be very high for speech and voice signal or music signal. And if you have higher speech, if you have higher crest factor for that, in that case, as we have derived relevance in between crest factor and power, it is reciprocal to each other. So higher the crest factor, lower the power, and lower the power, poor the SNR. But by using non-uniform quantization, we can improve that. And this is what I just want to convey in this session. So I hope that you have understood this session. You just write down your queries in comments so that I can understand what are the problems which is happening. And based on that, in future, I'll try to sort out all those issues. And in next session, I'll explain what is compounding. So that will be very interesting session, which will explain to you, like, see how we can implement non-uniform quantization. So just stay tuned with this channel. In next session, I'll explain what is compounding. Thank you so much for watching this video.